How are we going, everybody? And how's Cara? You're sitting here waiting for me to say hello to you, sweetheart? Good girl. Yes, come on, come out of the way. What I'm standing in front of here, or behind, folks, is our little potato patch. A few emails coming through, when's the right time to plant potatoes? So I thought, just to recap, a real simple one. These potatoes have been in the ground from, 4 years ago. We don't dig them all out completely, and you never get every single potato out of the ground. That's a fact, because you'll have potatoes as small as the size of a pea, all the way up to a decent-sized Nicola that's, a size like that. And that's what's happened here. We've had potatoes in from the previous seasons that have self-germinated. So planting potatoes, when do you plant them? Well, you plant them in areas where it's frost-free now. But if you've got frost-prone areas, well, you'll wait for the last frost to fall and you can plant them away. I'm not in that environment. I'm in the actual, in a frost-prone area. So these have self-germinated, and yes, these will get, can I get through? Come on, let me get through. Come on, move. She won't let me. All right, I'll walk around you. Sorry about that. She's in charge today. All right, we haven't seen each other for a while. I love you too. Come on. It's about 30 minutes. See this? That's frost damage. Nothing else but frost damage. This was up early from all the other ones, and it's been knocked back already. Now, that will come good again if you want to see. Look at that down there. Maybe from the same potato, maybe not, but down below here we've got one old one that's actually burned back and it's sprouting up again right next to it. So I dare say most of this will die back from a heavy frost, if we get any heavy frosts. But again, the bulb is strong in the soil and that should come back up again, so you'll get new growth coming through. I've had in the past in winter all this get knocked back by the frost maybe twice in that season, and at the end by springtime it's all come back up again and I've been able to harvest. You may not get the same harvest you want, because the way the potato grows is along the stem. You'll plant the potato in the ground, and the question has been posed, why do we mulch over the top of the potato? Well, if it gets exposed to the sunlight, it goes green, and that's a poisonous situation for you to be able to enjoy. So you don't want them sitting above ground. And as the potato grows up, the stem grows up, so the potatoes form. And as they form, they start to surface on top of the soil. Like these ones here, these are old ones. We're missing all the soil here. All you need to do is top it up with a little bit of soil and mulch. You don't have to do anything else. So when you plant your potatoes, try and get them down deep below and only have a small layer of soil or mulch over the top. And as they grow, you keep topping it up. In this case here, I just need to mound it up, add it on top. And you can mound up the soil. You don't have to put walls up and things like that. This is a potato patch. You can get a variety of potatoes into your ground. And if you remember last time when we planted them in the grow pots, if you've got a large potato, you can cut it in half or quarters, providing you leave an eye on each piece that you cut, because that's where it will sprout from. And you grow a new plant, you get multiple potatoes off that. The old little nursery rhyme, one potato, two potato, three potato, four, that's exactly what happens with one potato in the ground. And you get more and more each year. Folks, it's time to get your potatoes. They're out there at local garden centres. We've got them online. You get a free grow pot with it. There's Nicola, Dutch Cream, Russet, Sunset Pearl, and now we've also got Pontiac available. Not many left with the grow pots, so get them now while they last and enjoy planting your potatoes at home. From me, Vasily, Maresi. That's vasilisgarden.com.